happening? I'm trapped in a storm? How did I get here? And where is here? Wait, there's the lighthouse. I'll be safe if I can make it there. I hope. Please let me make it there. So surreal.
Famously called film Little Pieces of Time. But he could be talking about photography, as he likely was.
Okay. I'm in class. Everything's cool. I am okay.
From light to shadow. From color to chiaroscuro. Now, can you give me an example of a photographer who perfectly captured the human condition in black
and white? I didn't fall asleep, and that sure didn't feel like a dream.
Bueller.
Weird.
Diane Arbus.
There you go, Victoria. Why a-
Look at this crap. How can I show this to Mr. Jefferson? I can hear the class laughing at me now.
Arbus.
Because of her images of hopeless faces, you feel like totally haunted by the eyes of those sad mothers and children.
She saw humanity as tortured, right? Shh. I believe Max has taken what you kids call a selfie. A dumb word for a wonderful photographic tradition. And Max has a gift. Of course, as you all know, the photo portrait has been popular since the early 1800s. Your generation was not the first to use images for selfie expression. Sorry, I couldn't resist. The point remains that the portraiture has always been a vital aspect of art and photography for as long as it's been around. Now, Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits?
I did know, but I kind of forgot.
You either know this or not, Max. Is there anybody here who knows their stuff?
Louis Daguerre was a French painter who created daguerreotypes, a process that gave portraits a sharp reflective style like a mirror. Now you're totally stuck in the retro zone. Sad face.
Very good, Victoria. The Daguerrean process brought out fine detail in people's faces, making them extremely popular from the 1800s onward. The first American daguerreotype.
I haven't kept up with my journal as much as I should. Cornelius.
You can find out.
If anybody else looked at this, what would they think?
All about him in your textbook or even online. And guys, don't forget the deadline to submit a photo in the Everyday Heroes contest. I'll fly out with the winner to San Francisco, where you'll be feted by the art world. It's great exposure and it can kickstart a career in photography. So Stella and Alyssa, get it together. Taylor, don't hide. I'm still waiting for your entry too. And yes, Max, I see you pretending not to see me.
Victoria doesn't waste a second kissing ass.
Even if you're submitting your photo for the competition, everybody in class is turning in a photo, so you see the dilemma?
I know, Mr. Jefferson. I just worked so hard on the shot, and I'm sure you know what it's like to be consumed.
Hi, Kate.
Oh.
I just really
Hi,
think
Max.
Everyday Heroes is an important cultural event, and I want to represent Blackwell Academy.
You seem quiet today. Just thinking too much.
Out there in the world. Now, no matter who wins, this is just a bump on a bigger road. I don't want anybody.
I think Victoria has already won the contest. As usual.
She's got nothing on you, Max. Well, I should get going.
Yeah, me too. Talk to you later.
Sure.
I only want to share whatever gifts I have with the world.
I see you, Max Caulfield. Don't even think about leaving here until we talk about your entry. I'd never let one of photography's future stars avoid handing in her picture.
I didn't have any time. Way too much homework.
Max, you're a better photographer than a liar. Now, I know it's a drag to hear some old dude lecture you, but life won't wait for you to play catch up. You're young, the world is yours, blah, 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 right? But you do have a gift. You have the fever to take images, to frame the world only the way you envision it. Now, all you need is the courage to share your gift with others. And that's what separates the artist from the amateur.
You didn't tell me how cute I looked yet.
I was about to.
Welcome to the real world.
Just cute?
Hot.
Then I might send you a special picture.
I'm not paying $150 for
Because Max wants everybody to see how hip she is.
What's the point?
She plays it so sharp.
I need a serious time out in the bathroom. Splash water on my face and make sure I don't look like a total loser.
I hate that class. It's so fucking boring.
She's so fucking shy. She takes selfies with a giant camera.
To all of you American girls, it's sad to imagine a world without you. American girls, I'd like to be part of the world around
empty.
You.
Good. Nobody can see my meltdown except for me. I feel like the universe is taunting me everywhere I go today. It all started with that bizarro dream in class. Am I going crazy? Just relax. Stop torturing yourself. You have a gift. When a door closes, a window opens. Or something like that. Okay, girl, you don't get a photo op like this every day.
Cool, Nathan. Don't stress. You're okay, bro. Just count to three. Don't be scared. You own this school. If I wanted, I could blow it up. You're the boss. So what do you want?
I hope you check the perimeter, as my step-ass would say. Now, let's talk business.
I got nothing for you.
Wrong. You got hella cash.
That's my family, not me.
Oh, boo-hoo, poor little rich kid. I know you've been pumping drugs and shit to kids around here. I bet your respectable family would help me out if I went to them. Man, I can see the headlines now.
Leave them out of this, bitch!
I can tell everybody Nathan Prescott is a punk ass who begs like a little girl and talks to himself!
You don't know who the fuck I am or who you're messing around with!
Where'd you get that? What are you doing? Come on, put that thing down!
Don't ever tell me what to do! I'm so sick of people trying to control me!
You are going to get in hella more trouble for this than drugs.
Nobody would ever even miss your punk ass, would they?
Get that gun away from me, psycho!
No!
Whoa. What the fuck? How can that be? I was in the bathroom. He shot that poor girl. I held up my hand. And then I was back here.
As he likely was. These pieces of time can frame us in...
I already heard this lecture.
From light to shadow. From color...
Now Kate is being hassled again. And if Victoria's phone rings... This is real.
Now, shit! Can you give me an example of a photographer?
I cannot believe this.
Capture the human condition in black and white.
Okay, if I'm crazy,
anybody?
I might as well go all the way.
Bueller?
Diane.
Can I actually reverse time?
Here you go, Victoria. Why Arbus?
I did it.
Can you give me
I
an
actually
example
did
of a photographer who perfectly captured the human
time
in black
machine.
And white? Anybody? Bueller?
Max, don't freak out. Not yet.
There you go, Victoria. Why Arbus?
When I took my selfie, Jefferson asked me a question. If he does again, I'll know this is for real.
What you kids call a selfie. A dumb word for a wonderful photographic tradition. And Max has a gift.
I know I'm not dreaming
this. You all know, the
it's real.
Portrait has been popular
I can tell.
Since the early 1800s. Your generation
so I can go back in time.
For selfie expression.
What if that girl isn't dead yet?
I couldn't resist. The point
can I save
that
her?
The portraiture has always been a vital aspect of art and photography. First,
I need to go to the bathroom quickly and check it out.
Now, Max, since you've captured our interest and clearly want to join the conversation, can you please... tell us the name of the process that gave birth to the first self-portraits.
I'm sorry, but I really have to use the bathroom.
Nice try, Max. But you're not gonna get away that easy. We can talk more after class. Is there anybody
oh,
here
shit.
Who knows their stuff?
Jefferson wants to keep me after class.
Was a French painter.
And I need time to save that girl.
A process that gave portraits a sharp reflective style like a mirror. Now you're totally stuck in the retro zone. Sad face.
Very good, Victoria.
What if I rewind
the
again
process.
And give him the right answer?
The Daguerrean process, invented by a French painter named Louis Daguerre around 1830.
Somebody has been reading as well as posing. Nice work, Max. The Daguerrean process made portraiture hugely popular, mainly because it gave the subjects clear, defined features. You can learn more when you actually finish reading the assigned chapters. Max is so far way ahead of Evan. And guys, don't forget the deadline to submit a photo in the Everyday Heroes contest. I'll fly out with the winner to San Francisco, where you'll be feted by the art world. It's great exposure, and it can kickstart a career in photography. So Stella and Alyssa, get it together. Taylor, don't hide. I'm still waiting for your entry, too. And yes, Max, I see you pretending not to see me.
Max, you are not crazy. You are not dreaming. It's time to be an everyday hero.
Yes, Victoria, you still have to do your homework this week. I see you, Max Caulfield. Don't even think about leaving here until we talk about your entry. I'd never let one of
I'm not avoiding, just...
biding time? Waiting for the elusive right moment?
Exactly.
Max, don't wait too long. John Lennon once said that life is what happens while you're busy making other plans. Go on now. Don't let me stop you. Yes, Victor.
Excuse me, Mr. Jefferson, can I talk to you for a moment?
Yes, excuse you.
No, Victoria, excuse us. I'd never let one of photography's future stars avoid...
I'm on top of it. I think John Lennon once said that life is what happens while you're busy making other plans.
Max, you're on fire today. All the right answers, good. Make sure you finish working on it by today. I have faith in you.
I hope I have enough time to get to the bathroom. Please, please.
What would anybody want to carry?
Yo, Daniel.
You know I don't want teams.
I hate that science class.
Okay, Max, retrace every step. I washed my face. I shredded my photo. Then the butterfly flew in, and I took a photo.
Leave them out of this, bitch!
I can tell everybody Nathan Prescott is a punk ass who begs like a little girl and talks to himself!
You don't know who the fuck I am or who you're messing around with!
Where'd you get that? What are you doing? Come
don't
on, put that
ever
thing down!
Tell me what to do!
I need a hammer to break it open!
Of people trying to control me!
You are going to get in hella more trouble for this than drugs!
Nobody would ever even miss your punk ass, would they?
Get that gun away from me, psycho!
I need a hammer to break it open!
To control me!
You are going to get in hella more trouble for this than drugs!
Or even miss your punk ass, would they?
Get that gun away from me, psycho! For this than drugs.
No way!
Don't ever touch me again, freak!
Another shitty day.
That did not happen. This cannot be real. I just saw a girl get shot and then saved her. What the fuck is going on? Do not freak out.
Hey, do you hear that fire alarm? That means you should be outside.
I had to use the bathroom.
Girls always use that excuse.
Excuse for what?
For whatever you're up to. Your face is covered in guilt.
The alarm tripped me out.
Then trip on out of here, Missy. Or are you hiding something? Huh?
Thank you, Mr. Madsen. The situation is under control. There's no emergency here. Leave Miss Caulfield alone, and please turn off that alarm since that's your job. Hold on, Max. Come back here. You look a little stressed out. Are you okay?
I'm just a little worried about my future.
You're sweating pinballs. Is that all you're thinking about? You can always be upfront with me, Max. Or have you done something wrong? Is that it? Well, Max, talk to me.
I just saw Nathan Prescott waving a gun around in the girls' room.
Nathan Prescott? You sure?
Yes. He was in the bathroom talking to himself with a gun. I saw everything. He was babbling like crazy.
Okay, slow down. Slow down. So now you saw this without him seeing you.
I was hiding behind a stall. I have the right to be there. It's the girls' room.
I know. I just want to be completely clear what happened. Mr. Prescott happens to be from the town's most distinguished family, and one of Blackwell's most honored students. So it's hard for me to see him brandishing a weapon in the girls' bathroom. So what happened next?
Then Then he left. I ran out here wondering what to do. Are you gonna bust him?
This is a serious charge. I'll look into the matter personally. Thank you for bringing it to my attention.
That's it? After what I told
you? We'll continue this discussion later in my office. Please go outside with the rest of your class now, Miss Caulfield.
Of course this academic drone won't do anything, since the Prescott family owns Blackwell now. Should I rewind and change my story?
Nathan Prescott, please come to the front office. Thank you.
Rachel Amber. She looks so hopeful and pretty. I wonder what happened to her. Okay, I better get to my dorm and grab that flash drive. I bet the Blackwell founders would shit cats if they saw today's student body walking around like zombies on their phones. Yo, Justin.
Check out the Max. Come to Thrash?
Thrash? You mean stage diving, or...?
You're such a poser. If you can't even name a simple nose slide or a tray flip, you should walk on.
Yo, Justin.
Check out the mat.
I came to nose slide, but I'd love to see somebody do a tray flip.
Oh, sick. You're not a poser.
Nah, I just can't skate worth shit.
Aw, check it. We're gonna destroy some rails for you. What do you want to see?
Go for a tree flip.
Let's get Trevor all over that action. Oh, ow. Ooh.
Come on, Logan. Bring it, Brock. Yeah!
I need to go to my room and return Warren's flash drive.
It's Max Caulfield, the selfie hoe of Blackwell. What a lame gimmick. Even Mark, Mr. Jefferson, falls for your waif hipster bullshit. The Daguerrean process, sir. You could barely even say that. I guess you got your meds filled. Since you know all the answers, I guess you have to find another way into the dorm. We ain't moving. Oh, wait. Hold that pose. So original. Don't worry, Max. I'll put a vintage filter on it right before I post it all over social medias. Now, why don't you go fuck your selfie?
Oh, yes, Victoria. I'll get your bony ass out of my way. I don't want to mess with that ladder and hurt poor Samuel.
I just want to get Victoria. I could crank the sprinkler up and give Victoria and her clones incentive to beat it. There goes Samuel da Vinci to paint the window. Okay, let's see if this works.
What the hell? Are you kidding? Look at this!
Chill, Victoria. It's just water.
Yeah, water on my cashmere. Do you know how much this fucking outfit costs?
You look great.
I can't even chill on the steps.
Oh, Samuel, sorry. Wet paint is not good for hair, nope. Sorry.
Get the hell away from me, weirdo!
Hold on. We'll get some towels. We'll be right back.
So move your ass before I dry.
It worked. Don't mess with Max, bitches.
Nice, bro.
Hi, Kate.
Hey, Max.
You look down. You okay?
I'm kind of over humanity today. Sorry to be a drama queen.
Is there anything...
Max, I'd like to be alone, if you don't mind. I'm sorry.
Glad to see our campus is eco-friendly. Hey, Victoria.
What do you want, Max?
I am sorry. That's an awesome cashmere coat.
It was. But there'll be another.
Well, you always seem to know how to pick the right outfits.
Awesome. I do have some talent. Mr. Jefferson told me.
I've seen your pictures. You have a great eye. Richard Avedon-esque.
He's one of my heroes. Thanks, Max. I hope those sluts get me a towel before they hang a sign on me. You deserve a better shot. Sorry about blocking you and the go fuck your selfie. Yeah.
That was mean, but pretty funny.
One of those days, you know?
I know exactly what you mean, Victoria. I'll see you later.
Au revoir.
Victoria probably played me.
We took so long.
How sad. I didn't write anything. I have nothing to say. Home sweet home. My favorite cocoon. Max Caulfield Photo Memorial Wall.
You are thirsty. I'm the worst baby mama. Drink up. Philip Lorca de Corsia, my man. I don't think I could take my camera to those places. Look at that shot. I love Julia Cameron's Victorian vibe. Talk about analog cameras. Ah, Dolly, what a fantastic eye. He could truly freeze time. Looks like Dana left me a little post-it note. Great. Now I have to go get the flash drive from Dana's room.
You can't get out now, Dana. So tell me the truth or rot in there.
Welcome to the real drama queens of Blackwell.
Let me out, Juliet. This is so stupid.
Hey, Juliet. Is everything cool?
Oh yes, Max. I've locked Dana in the room because we're cool.
You are ridiculous.
What did she do?
What didn't she do? Dana's been sexting with my boyfriend.
Ouch. How did you find out?
Why do you care? Why are you even asking me? You never talk. Just zone out with your camera.
That's why I'm talking to you now.
What's my last name?
Juliet. Juliet Olson.
That was truly sad. Thanks for your concern, Max Caulfield. By the way, Juliet Watson.
Hey, Juliet.
Oh, yes, Max.
Let me out, Juliet. This is
Juliet
so
Watson,
stupid.
You be nice.
I'm flattered. I didn't even think you knew my name at all.
Of course I do.
Thanks. I locked Dana in because she was sexting Zach, my boyfriend.
You are ridiculous.
Unbelievable.
How do you know?
Victoria Chase. You know her.
You could say that.
You don't let me out.
But why would Dana go after your boyfriend?
According to Victoria, Dana would do anything to date a quarterback.
According to Victoria? Huh.
She saw the sext, and Zachary won't answer his phone. Once Dana admits it, she can go. Straight to hell.
Max, I swear I didn't do anything. But I bet Victoria did. I know the proof is in her
room. I'll give Victoria props for not posting my photo. Boom! This is the email I need to show Juliet. Now I have to print this fast and get the hell out of here. This better convince Juliet that Dana is innocent. Speaking of selfies, let's play a little photo Tetris and leave Victoria a message. Let's move this here, and this one there. A pattern is emerging. Juliet, read this.
Of course. I'm an asshole. I'm sorry, Dana.
You are.
and I hope so. You really think I'd mess around with Zachary?
No, but I get stupid jealous. I owe you dinner. Still love me?
And you do my laundry.
Thanks, Max. You're like the Blackwell Ninja. Now let's see what Zach has to say about Victoria.
You set me free. Thank you. Warren's flash drive is on my desk.
Almost done. Get the flash drive and then I'll go see Warren.
Must protect my precious so Max never has to chase it down again.
That looks like a home pregnancy test. Hey, Dana.
Seriously, thanks again. I can't believe Juliet locked me in my own room. Real mature.
Poor Juliet gets her rage on. I hope she doesn't kill Victoria.
Zachary should worry, too. As if I'd let that ego-case jockstrap touch me. But I bet Victoria would be all over that action. Or has been. Max, you're smart to be a loner here. Though Warren obviously likes hanging with you.
He's a good guy. A geek like me.
You saw the files in his flash drive. Tons of crazy shit. Films I've never even heard of. And in a special folder called Max.
Yeah, okay. I gotcha.
This shit.
Ow!
Damn, I better rewind.
Alyssa, move your head.
If you insist, Max.
Now that's what I'm talking about. I actually helped somebody. Glad to see our campus is eco-friendly.
So don't think I'm blind. I see everything here at Blackwell. Do you understand what I'm saying?
No, and leave me alone.
Hey, why don't you leave her alone?
Excuse us, this is official campus business.
Excuse me, you shouldn't be yelling at students or bullying them.
Hey, nobody is bullying anybody. I'm doing my job.
No, you're not.
You're part of the problem, Missy. I will remember this conversation.
Oh, Max, that was great. I think you scared him for once. I have to go, but thank you. It means a lot.
Anytime, Kate. I felt like an everyday hero helping Kate, but now Officer David Dickhead is after me. Maybe I should rewind and mind my own business? I'm glad I stepped in that time. Can't stand to see people being bullied. Now this really pisses me off. So entitled.
Sorry, handicapped folks. My truck needs these two spots more than you do. Bastard. It's not a dirty window unless somebody writes clean me on it. I could use this picture for a series on Arcadia Bay lots.
Yo, Max, check it out. What up, Max? How are you?
Here's your flash. Thanks.
No problem. Check out my new wheels.
Cool. Very old school.
1978, to be exact. Now we can go to the drive-in. There's one in Newburgh just 60 miles away.
You're in the wrong time, Warren. But then, so am I.
You okay?
It's been one strange fucking day.
I bet. I heard Victoria got a face full of paint. I'd pay money to see a photo of that.
I don't want to talk about it.
Jeez, you're a little miss sensitive today.
I wouldn't push your luck, Warren. Not in the mood today.
So, did you get a chance to check out the movie booty on my flash drive?
Yeah, thanks. You had some cool shit on there, from Akira to Twilight Zone, which seems apropos today.
I consider myself a pop cultural pirate connoisseur.
That does sound better than thief.
Ha ha. Make sure you watch Cannibal Holocaust.
No fucking way will I watch that. My mind is twisted enough.
I laughed my ass off.
So you're sensitive.
Ouch, that sounds awful the way you say it.
No, I was impressed you had faster pussycat kill.
Russ Mayer was a genius of black and white, plus babes with breasts.
Who would beat your sensitive ass down?
If I was lucky. Speaking of hip and fast, we should cruise out in my car to an actual movie this week. But you seem distracted.
I don't want to speak about it. This is kind of a crazy day for me. I mean, I literally think I'm going crazy.
I may be a pest, but I'm a good listener.
For reals, Warren, this is between you and me, not social media.
Don't insult me. Max, go on.
I had this incredibly bizarro experience in Mr. Jefferson's class today. I mean, life-changing. Have you ever had a dream so real it was like a movie?
Max Caulfield, right? You're one of the Jefferson's photo groupies?
I'm one of his students.
What the fuck ever? I know you like to take pictures, especially when you're hiding out in the bathrooms. You best tell me what you told the principal. Now. Answer me, bitch!
I told him the truth. A student had a gun.
No, you told him I had a gun. That's why he dragged me into his office.
And did what? Give you a stern lecture?
Nobody. Nobody lectures me. Everyone tries, though. They try.
You should talk to somebody, Nathan.
Do not analyze me! I pay people for that. Worry about yourself, Max Caulfield.
Take a step back, Nathan Prescott.
Oh man, you're telling me what to do?
Get away from her, dude!
Hey! Leave him alone!
Nobody tells me what to do! Not my parents, not the principal,
that.
Or that whore
right
in the bathroom!
Max? Chloe?
No way. You again.
Warren!
Go! Go! I got this!
Get in, Max!
Get your punk asses out of there now! Don't even try to run! Nobody! Nobody!
Man, Nathan Prescott is messed up. And dangerous. This day never ends.
Oh, and thanks, Chloe. After 5 years, you're still Max Caulfield. Don't give me the guilty face. At least pretend you're glad to see me.
I am seriously glad to see you. Oh, and thanks, Chloe. It makes perfect sense I'd see you today.
Yes, it's been that kind of day. So what did that freak want with you?
Hopefully nothing after today. So, how do you know Nathan?
He's just another Arcadia asshole. Your friend really took a beatdown for you.
Warren? Yeah, I owe him big time.
You're not the only one in debt. And you're already causing trouble.
I thought it would be quiet here. Feels so weird to be back.
So I guess Seattle sucked hard?
I guess. It was cool, but I felt kind of lonely, out of my league.
I would think you'd fit right in with the art school hipsters.
Right. You look like the cover of hipstergirl.com.
At least you're still a smartass.
That's why I'm here.
Please, girl. You came back for Blackwell Academy.
Of course, it's one of the best photography programs in the country. And my favorite teacher, Mark Jefferson.
So you came back to Arcadia for a teacher, not your best friend.
Don't you think I'm happy to see you?
No. You were happy to wait 5 years without a call or even a text.
I'm sorry. I know things were tough on you when I left.
How do you know? You weren't even here.
I didn't order my parents to move specifically to fuck you over, Chloe.
You've been at Blackwell for almost a month without letting me know. Enough said.
I just wanted to settle in first and not be such a shy, cliche geek. I totally would have contacted you.
I bet you don't use these sad excuses on Mr. Jefferson. Don't use them on me, Max. Haven't heard that one in a while.
Not everything changes. Except my camera has officially taken a shit.
My step-douche has a boatload of tools. Maybe you can fix it in my place.
I need very specific, tiny tools.
Nerd alert. My stepdad has a fully stocked garage. And he actually is a tiny tool. Welcome home, Max. Come on in, don't be shy.
The house still looks nice.
Home, shit, home. My room looks a bit different than the last time you saw it.
It's cool. At least we can chill out.
This isn't exactly my chill-out zone. My step-fuhrer makes sure of that. Come in and close the door. Put on some music while I medicate.
It won't play without any power.
So tell me, what does Max Caulfield do for fun now that she's a grown-up?
I don't feel grown-up, just more confused as I get older. Especially after today.
Gee, thanks. I was hoping to hear something positive.
About me?
No, about me. Duh. I thought you'd at least be happy taking photos. Forget it. So tell me.
I take photos. Of me, the world, everything. It may sound sad, but I have a blast.
It doesn't sound that sad.
I'm happiest when I've got a great image in my lens. I'm not lonely, not afraid.
Now that's more inspiring. I don't feel so totally hopeless. Hey, give me that!
Sorry, I wasn't trying to be nosy. Obviously, she was a good friend.
It's putting it mildly.
That's Rachel Amber. Her missing person posters are all over Blackwell.
Yeah, I put them up. She was my angel. After my dad died and you moved, I felt abandoned. Rachel saved my life.
Man, I had no idea.
Well, you never made much effort to find out. I was 14. We were best friends.
I never forgot, even if I was an asshole and didn't keep in touch. But you had Rachel.
Rachel had my back. We were gonna kick the world's ass. You would laugh at how different we were. She wanted to be a star.
She looks like a model.
That was her plan. Our plan. Get the hell out of Bigfootville and into Los Angeles.
So what happened? Did your folks, your mom, try to stop you?
My mom was too busy hooked up with Sergeant Shithead.
I feel the love. Now, when did Rachel actually disappear?
6 months ago. She just left Arcadia. Without a word. Without me.
How do you know she disappeared? Maybe she wanted to start a totally new life.
Unlike you, she would have told me, okay? Something happened to her.
I believe you. I'm just trying to get all deductive.
Before Rachel left, she said she met somebody who changed her life. Then poof.
And you haven't heard anything from her since?
Like everybody in my life. My dad, you, and Rachel. Gone. Can you put on some music now? Anyway, you can find tools to fix your camera in the garage.
Chloe, are you okay?
Sure, I'm awesome. I just want to blaze and be alone for a moment. My step-ass keeps tools down in the garage. I bet you can find something to fix your camera.
This must be Chloe's parents' room. Man, I am nosy today. You've been resurrected, Birdie. Fly, be free. I haven't seen this place in 5 years. Seems like forever. Brr, I can feel autumn pushing out the summer. We made this grave for Chloe's kitty. Poor Bongo. He never saw that car coming. That took Chloe and me the whole day to draw. It's almost invisible now.
Rob's in the kitchen making pizza. Somewhere down in the river. I'm singing songs about the future.
I should be able to find the tools I need here. These are way too big. I need tiny tools for that camera. Poor little deer. It's not enough to kill you, they have to display your head. Fingers. Boom, precision screwdrivers. Except I can't reach them. That was very smart, dumbass. No can reach. Yes, you have mad skills, Max. Chloe's stepdad is head of security at Blackwell. He wants to put surveillance cameras all over the school? How paranoid can you get? Chloe's stepfather is this asshole from Blackwell? You've gotta be shitting me.
You found the tools. Sweet. You can sit at my desk and fix your camera. So?
I can't fix this thing.
Are these your new photos?
Yeah, I just took them today.
Let me see. Wait, I've seen this before. No way. When did you take this? You took this photo, you brat? In the bathroom today. You set off the alarm. That's why Nathan raged after you. It totally makes sense. You hella saved my life. Now tell me the truth, Max.
I was there, hiding in the corner.
Damn, you're a ninja.
A ninja would have cut Nathan's head off. I just took a butterfly photo.
That is so badass.
Oh yeah, I almost wet myself when I saw the gun.
So, did you recognize me?
I wasn't sure.
I know I look a lot different.
I was scared, too. I couldn't see straight.
I don't blame you, Max.
Like you said, it's been that kind of day.
So you must have overheard our conversation.
I was freaking out. I could only hear Nathan ranting.
So then you did hear us.
Okay, I only heard something about money, drugs, but that's it.
Now for the big question. Did you tell anybody?
Absolutely. Nathan Prescott had a fucking gun on you.
Gutless prick. That was scary. Who did you tell?
The principal. But he didn't seem to believe me.
The principal? Are you still 12? That drunk jackass only cares about cash for Blackwell Academy. Don't trust him.
I didn't mention you at all. Swear.
Thank God. I'll tell you more someday. And I seriously owe you, Max. I know it was your birthday last month. This was my real father's camera. I want you to have it.
That's so cool you remembered my birthday. But I can't take this.
Of course you can. My dad would be pissed if I never used it, and now I know it'll be used awesomely. And I'll snag this picture as a symbol of our reunion. Cool?
Yes, of course it's cool. Thank you. This camera is so sweet.
Now that we got that mushy shit out of the way, I feel like stage diving. Let's thrash this place.
You're crazy.
Yep, I'm fucking insane in the brain. Let's dance! Shake that phony white ass. Or take my picture with your new camera. This song fucking rules. Can't dance, hippie? Come on. Rock out, girl. Yes, break it down, Max.
Yo, turn it off.
How many times have I told you to stop blasting that punk shit?
Dude, the music's not even on. Asshole.
I'm coming up. We need to talk.
Oh, no fucking way. You need to hide now. My stepdad will kill me if he finds you here.
Chloe, what's going on? Open this door, please.
Chill, I'm changing. Is that okay? Max, find a place to hide now.
Chloe.
I'm coming.
What are you doing? Chloe, you're stalling.
I'm changing. Give me a minute.
Don't get smart. Chloe, you're stalling.
I'm changing. Give me a minute.
Don't get smart. Just let me in. Now. Please.
1 second. My bra is stuck.
I'm not screwing around, soldier. Chloe, open this door.
Shit.
What's going on in here?
Jesus, I'm just trying on clothes. You're so friggin' paranoid.
Yeah, combat will do that to you. One of my guns is missing. Did you take it?
Oh God, I didn't take your stupid gun. You do know I believe in gun control?
Wait, is that grass? You been toking up again in here?
Oh yeah, guns, weed. You were tripping balls.
I'm sick of your disrespect. Tell me the truth, that's an order.
Whose is it?
I'm sorry. That was my joint.
Well, well. I don't like strangers in my home. Especially dopers. So you're bringing drugs into my home. How about if I call the police? That'd screw up your spotless Blackwell record. You do seem to get around, Max. I'm sick of you losers dragging Chloe down. Missy, you sure do like to pop up and start trouble. Like this afternoon. You don't have anything smart to say now, do
you? Get the hell away from her, man. Stop harassing my friends.
You don't have any friends.
Like you know. You're not even a real cop. You're a fucking security guard.
I was a soldier, Chloe. And Max, if I see you here again, you'll learn all about real trouble.
Because you're such a badass, Max, let me show you my new toy. I'm Price. Chloe Price. Bang!
Jesus, put that thing down!
Chillax, sister. It's not even loaded. Yet.
I thought you believed in gun control.
Yes, I believe I should control the gun. It's the men who need to be checked. You trust Nathan or David? Thanks for taking the heat. We totally smacked his punk ass down, Max. He's no match for you and me now. That was an epic win. Anyway, let's sneak out the window. There is one cool place we can hang in this hick hole.
Man, that did not go well for me. If I want to keep my Blackwell scholarship, I shouldn't lie for anybody, even Chloe. I have to think about my own future.
Awesome sauce? Totally reminds me of when we were kids. Come on, Slowpoke!
Hold on. I haven't been here in forever. So why do I feel like I was just here? Whoa. This is the exact same path I was on during my nightmare today. Birds are so lucky, they can always escape. Clearly, the Bigfoots are everywhere. How long has that been here? Sure you don't want to be alone?
Have a seat, Pete.
You're in a good mood.
Seeing my step dork get played makes me happy.
I'm not as brave as you. And David is indeed a step douche.
I'm sorry you had to experience it firsthand.
You have to live with him. Has he always been this way?
Ever since my desperate mom dragged his ass to our home, I never trusted David.
He freaked out on poor Kate Marsh today.
I know her. She's cool. Only that prick would bully her.
He has some kind of weird agenda.
He has a lot of secret files. Rambo still thinks he's gathering enemy intelligence. Did you take a peek?
You know, I wanted to, but I realized I have enough mystery in my life.
I'd like to find out. I bet he's got some serious porn in there.
Ugh.
Good thing you didn't look. He's a total surveillance fetish. Where are there spy cams in the house?
Sometimes ignorance is bliss.
No wonder I'm so miserable. Everybody in this town knows everybody's secrets.
What's Nathan's secret?
He's an elite asshole who sells bad shit cut with laxative. And he dosed me with some drug in his room.
What?
I met him in some shithole bar that didn't card me. He was too rich for the place and too wasted, and he kept flashing bills.
Just tell me what happened, Chloe. Now.
I was an idiot. I thought he was so blazed it would be an easy score.
You needed money that bad?
Actually, yes. I owe big time. And I thought I'd have enough for me and Rachel if she showed up.
How much do you owe?
$3,000 plus interest. And before I could get a chunk of that from Nathan, he dosed my drink with some shit.
God, Chloe. I can't believe this. I mean, I do. Then what?
I know I passed out on the floor. I woke up and that perv was smiling, crawling towards me with a camera.
Go on.
Everything was a blur. I tried to kick him in the balls and broke a lamp. Nathan freaked, so I managed to bum rush the door and get the hell out. Max, it was insane.
Chloe, that is so fucked up. What did you do then?
I figured I would make him pay me to keep quiet. So we met in the bathroom.
And he brought a gun.
That was Nathan's last mistake.
He's still dangerous, Chloe. Not just to you.
Oh, good thing you notified the principal. I feel safer already.
I won't always be there to save you.
You were here today, Max. You saved me. I'm still tripping on that. Seeing you after all these years feels like...
destiny.
If this is destiny, I hope we can find Rachel. I miss her, Max. This shit pit has taken away everyone I've ever loved. I'd like to drop a bomb on Arcadia Bay and turn it to fucking glass.
Straight for the town. Chloe, you're here. I'm back. Oh my lord, this is real. It's real. Oh man, this sucks.
Max, what's going on? He totally blacked out.
I didn't black out. I had another vision. The town is going to get wiped out by a tornado.
Oregon gets about 5 tornadoes every 20 years. You just zoned.
No, I saw it. I could actually feel the electricity in the air.
Come on, take a breath, okay?
Chloe, I'm not crazy. But there's something else I have to tell you. Something hardcore.
Talk to me, Max.
I
had this same vision earlier in class. When I came out of it, I discovered I could reverse time. Like I said, not crazy.
But high, right?
Listen to me. How do you think I saved you in the bathroom?
By reversing time? Yeah, sure.
I saw you get shot, Chloe. Saw you actually die. I was able to go back and hit the fire alarm.
Okay, I see you're a geek now with a great imagination, but this isn't anime or a video game. People don't have those powers, Max.
I don't know what I have, but I have it. And I'm scared shitless.
You need to get high. It's been a hell insane fucking day. What the hell is this?
Snowflakes?
It's like 80 degrees. How?
Climate change. Or a storm is coming.
Max, start from the beginning. Tell me everything.
Through the blizzard.